Hello, my name is Retract Ebor. It's Robbie Carter backwards. It's opposite day, in case you didn't know. I figured I'd celebrate the occasion since comedy's all about subverting expectations. You know, last time I came here, I was dressed a bit more fancy. It was my first time here. So I went more casual tonight. Taco Bell, awesome. And last time I talked about adulthood, so today I'm going to talk about my childhood. And since this is a stand-up comedy, I'll feel more comfortable when nobody laughs. Okay, so let's get to it. My childhood was a dark one. Having grown up in the fields of Shropshire's Hay as a lonely corn tussler, every winter another sibling would die from the bitter cold. And by the time I reached the age when we milked goats, I had but 3 toes left and less teeth than a shelled turtle. Now, my childhood was nothing like that. actually, I was pretty good. I went to a nice school, and my parents were middle class, middle aged, middle size. But I was a stupid kid. Yeah, I think childhood gets all this good rep because the whole idea that kids are blissfully unaware of their surroundings because they don't know things, they don't really know like the evils of the world yet. They live a simpler life and are more prone to joy as a result. But it is opposite day, and we must embrace the duality of life. Take me for example. Like any other kid, I was blissfully unaware. And sure, there was bliss, but holy fuck was I unaware! I mean, like this time, in second grade, my school had the lunches we could get, and they also had, you could get a cookie for a dollar every day, and I'd never tried it, so I asked my mom that night, and she got it from her purse, and I held on to it all night. On my way to school, I held on to that single dollar bill, because I was determined to get that cookie, and I just held it out of my hand. And recess rolls around, right before lunch, and it's raining outside, so they stuff all the kids inside the cafeteria, and everyone's just kind of talking to each other. My friends Michael and Dieter were playing cards. They were playing the game Spit, if any of you know that. And I wasn't close to either of them, but I wanted to be. So I get over to them, and I kind of get like into the game. I'm leaning over Michael's shoulder, and I'm like cheering him on. Come on, get Dieter! Just waving that dollar bill in my hand. And then the security guard walks over. Yeah, and he calls my mom, sits me down in the principal's office, and they explain that they caught me red-handed gambling.
Yeah.
That wasn't the only vice I committed during my elementary years. There was also lust, because my friend Sean, he had finally found it. The body part that had eluded the imaginations of every preteen boy. The vagina. And he found it on something called the internet. It just started coming up. He told his findings of his research to us orally as we listened with attentive ears, and he just kind of said,
"You know, it's kind of like 3 lines just going up and down all next to each other." Needless to say, he became a world-famous journalist, but
imagine how goddamn confusing that was to me. 3 fucking parallel lines running vertically where the pee-pee was supposed to be? You know what image came to my mind when he described the vagina? An air vent! I imagine the goddamn air vent made out of flesh. I couldn't even conceive how a penis was meant to enter that. Thankfully, I found porn later on. And I realized how silly I was, because vaginas are even more confusing than that. But yeah, that's all I got. Thank you.